Okay, so, there was a little hiccup, maybe, with my finding the save file, but I found it. So what we did, yesterday was we went straight to the Pokemon professor, the most awesome of the Pokemon professors because of the Hawaiian shirt. Really, that's a guy that likes to hang loose. And we got our first Pokemon, and we beat up a kid much, much younger than us. We made him cry, he ran home to his father, and now we are about to learn how to catch Pokemon. Hey there, little Roids. Now that you and Theo are here, it's time to begin your first lesson as a Pokemon trainer and a field research aide. Now watch closely. Wild Pokemon, as you probably already know, inhabit tall grass. But that's not the only place. You can also find them in caves, in water, and even in cities if you know where to look. Still, tall grass is going to be your best bet for finding new Pokemon. Simply take a few steps in and... look! It's a wild Chinmunk! They're very common around here. They are, and I anticipate we'll have one. They're not too bad once you get them evolved, so... not the worst bet. Probably won't make it the entire way, but not the worst bet. It hasn't noticed me yet, so now's my chance. I feel like he's gonna, like, tackle it or something. Just grab it by the shoulders and forcibly put it in a Pokeball. This little guy was the other starter Pokemon you could have received. I think he's taken a shine to me. I rather like him too, so I'm gonna keep him. That begs the question, what was he going to do with the Pokemon if he decided he didn't want to keep them? Because we're the only two working for him. Maybe he was going to go to the Pokemon shelter, where unwanted Pokemon go. Now the next step is to weaken the enemy Pokemon to make it easier to catch. Orchinks, you scratch! Jin! I do not know. That was probably not as high-pitched as that sound should have been for a Pokemon. Probably not. Such a happy little cat Pokemon. Bouncing. And that's how it's done. Now, Chinmunk are fairly easy. But you're sure to encounter Pokemon that are a lot harder to capture. For those, you might need to inflict them with status effects or use a special Pokeball. Ah, but I'm sure you'll get the hang of it before too long. Little Roids, Theo, these are for you. So because we've now received our a Pokedex, we'll be able to figure out exactly how many Pokemon we see, if we're doing a good job, because we are getting paid for this. We are trying to support our elderly aunts. So, filling up our Pokedex is apparently the job we've been hired to do. It's very important for my research, so make sure to fill it out as much as possible. Also, I want you to have these. And he's going to hand us Pokeballs, and now because we have Pokeballs, any Pokemon we encounter, the first one in any location, is the only one we can catch. And our first Pokemon will actually be in Mokeytown since we've got this bit of grass. Because, you know, it is technically a new location. What's that thing the kids always say? Gotta catch 'em all. Wink, wink. Nudge, nudge. All those kids playing Pokemon Red and Pokemon Blue. If you run out, you can pick up some more at any Pokemon. Mokeytown doesn't have one of those. But there's one in Kevlar Town, on the other side of Route 1. So with that said, your lesson is now over. Oh, but you two have Pokepods, don't you? Here, let me input my number. Register Professor Bamboo in the Pokepod. You can give me a call anytime, and I'll take a look at how your Pokedex is coming along. If you do a good job collecting many different kinds of Pokemon, I might even have special rewards for you. With that said, I'm going back to my lab. Best of luck on your journeys, both of you. And then he walks away and out of our lives for actually a substantial amount of time. Little Royce, I don't care that you got the stronger starter. I'm still going to be the best trainer ever. I'll catch tons of Pokemon, and we'll win every battle, except that first one, which I won. Can't deny that, little kid. You just wait and see. I just want to beat him at every turn. I just want to crush his dreams. I want him to run back crying to his father again. I mean, what kind of Pokemon trainer wouldn't just explore this patch of grass? He just walks straight on. He's like, I don't care. I know I just said I was going to catch all the Pokemon, but I'll do it over there. But then again, my Pokemon are apparently the only ones that die. So. Come on. I know you're in here. Do-do-do-do-do. I've always thought it must look really weird for people not being Pokemon trainers, like watching me just like stumble through the tall grass for substantial amounts of time, just walking in circles. Okay, here we go. First Pokemon. I hope I don't kill it. That wouldn't be good. And like you said, Chinmunks are really common, so it's not a surprise we encountered one. But it's our Chinmunk. It's only a level 2. We could probably just catch it now, because I'd be worried about even tackling it a second time. Oops. With Nuzlocke, if you kill the Pokemon, then you don't get to catch another one, that's it. And because this Pokemon Uranium actually has Nuzlocke mode built into it, like, you can't be like, oh, I was just kidding. There's not a way to cheat. Ah, oh, Chinmunk. Spunky. We got a spunky one. I'll try one more Pokeball. If not, I guess I'll have to try tackling it. Stay. Yeah. That's really good, because I didn't want to have to use a third Pokeball on a Chinmunk. A level 2 Chinmunk. Would not be a good start. The length of Chinmunk's stripes determine its authority in a group. He looks like a Roger to me. Blanket and Roger. Okay. So we're gonna do a little grinding, and I'll probably do some grinding off camera just because with the Nuzlocke you end up doing a lot of it. And I'll probably go heal him first before I try to even get him up from level 2 so he doesn't immediately die. And then I forgot my auntie gave me the running shoes. I still have that rare candy that one of the neighbors gave me, and we'll see if I want to use that right off the bat. it shouldn't be too difficult to get Chinmunk at least up to level 5. So then he can make it out of Route 1 without just completely getting decimated. It's quiet without you, you know. Did you ever talk to your neighbor, Cam? He's an electrician, you know. Seems to be moving up in the world. That was my rival's father with the red hair that was friends with my mother and father. Oops. Zeteron. Boop, 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 boop. Am I gonna see another one in here, or should I just go? Well, if I go into Route 1. Oh, oops. I got one. Didn't take as long as the first time. This level 2 Chinmunk has nothing on my level 2 Chinmunk. Its stripes are way longer. Way more alpha male. Let's see how much damage it does. If not, I'll switch. Oh! We'll just put in blanket. We have this taken out quicker. Do it, blanket. I think even with our attack being lowered, we'll take it out in one hit. Because I think Chinmunks are eventually electric, but I don't think they're electric yet. Yeah, I think they are electric now that I'm thinking about it. But I think they might have to wait till they evolve. Like, Chinmunks are actually a pretty useful Pokemon, down the line. They look a little derpy at the beginning, but their evolution's real cool. Just full of Chinmunks. Just full of Chinmunks. We'll just beat this one through so we don't have to share the experience. Hopefully. We'll see how that works. Oh, not good. I think he hit harder than me. No, he used Growl though. We'll probably be okay. Yeah, level up. Slightly less awful. Like I said last episode, the first couple episodes we're probably going to visit our elderly auntie a lot, just because she heals us. And we're going to try to get through Route 1. Because there are some trainers in Route 1 that want to battle. So you don't want to go into that underleveled. Because then you'll lose your Nuzlocke right away, and you'll be sad, and you'll feel bad about yourself. And I don't really feel like crying in a corner today. It's not built into my schedule. I've been playing your Wii Tennis! It feels good to get moving! My elderly aunt has so many great things to say. And it's nice that she's using the Wii. I bet that does get her moving. I don't want her health to deteriorate while I'm gone. So I got this job for her. Just take a step into Route 1 here. I believe the correct way to go would just be going forward. So we're gonna go down and see what's down here first. Again, if we encounter a Pokemon that's not a Chinmunk, then we'll catch it. If it's just a Chinmunk, then we can just beat it. As are the rules of Nuzlocke. Oh! But it's a Burby. So that means we're catching our second Pokemon. Or third Pokemon if you count the one we got from the professor. I mean, I wish it wasn't a level 2 Burby. Just gonna end up being more grinding that we have to do. But that's the way the cookie crumbles. You don't pick or choose when it comes to Nuzlocke. That was not so bad. I'm glad that wasn't as bad. Use. It defends itself by dazzling opponents, by flashing its brightly colored plumage. I'm going Mocha. Can't spell. And I think I can get at least another battle in before I have to go back to my elderly aunt. Oh, a Kabug. We don't get to catch it though. We've seen so far have been new Pokemon that they added for Pokemon Uranium. You'll see, it'll take a little bit before the old Pokemon start appearing. Like, you do see that he mentioned Mankeys in the last episode. You do see a lot of Mankeys in some area, which is weird because I don't remember seeing a lot of Mankeys in the first generation, actually. Stop lowering my attack! Stop making this last longer! I know you're adorable and could easily charm me, but that's not the point. I'm very charmed, I get it. You're dashing! The little barriers. Gonna charm me again. Oh, nope, string shot. I was like, if he lowers my attack more time, I might only be doing one damage each hit. I was getting to that point. There we go. Yay! No new moves, though. I do kind of remember that about Chinmunk, that it takes him a really long time to learn a third move, and I'm gonna do this real quick. I'm gonna tab my running shoes, so that way I don't have to keep pressing Z. Which was a nice little addition in this game, is you could just, if you're going to be the type of person who wants to run everywhere, which I don't know who'd wanna walk. I don't know what walking does for you, particularly. But, oh, I just walked directly into that woman. I was not paying attention to where I was going. I got a job, left my small town, and suddenly I, like, don't care about the small town life anymore. I'm like, get out of my way. I've got my running shoes. I've got places to be. This coffee's still warm, I feel so. Not really. It's quiet without you around, you know. Have you heard from my nephew, your father, lately? Must be tough being a ranger. And we do meet up with Dad a little bit later in the game. And it's just as awkward as you'd think it would be. Oh, we're going down. I wonder if this person wants to battle. I'd be nervous. Maybe just level him up one more time. Once he's at level 5, maybe it won't be so nerve-wracking to face someone in Route 1. So that's another thing I do remember about the part I did play from this game, is that some of the people you meet are like unnaturally hard for what route they're in. I wish, the one thing I do wish is that when you switch to Nuzlocke mode in Pokemon Uranium, that everyone had to play by Nuzlocke rules. So that people would get, like, really depressed when you, you know, defeated them in battle. Because you've killed all of their animals, all their pets. Just demolished them. Sadly, that's not the way this works. Everyone else is just going along their normal day. You can fight people multiple times, that's what your Pokepod's for. I don't think there's anything more- like, no status effect is really as annoying as accuracy down when they, like, spam it. Because you're just sitting here like, I could have ended this battle, like, a solid 3 turns ago. Burby fainted. One more Burby, and we might be ready to fight our first person, because I think Cubbugs don't give you as much experience. Bug Pokemon really never gave you much experience. He's so cute, yet his eyes are so unfeeling. He looks like a teddy bear, where the eyes are just, you know, stitched in. Nothing is scarier than a critical hit in a Nuzlocke. No, we got more than we would have if we fought a Chinmunk, I think. What was it, 16 with Chinmunk for level 2s? And we'll just switch in. Blanket. Blanket! No, we're probably okay. Because Gust only did 3 damage last time we fought a Burby. Oops. Okay. Don't want that to happen again. Go ahead, Blanket. That would have been really embarrassing if I lost my first Pokemon in Route 1, actually. That's okay. I got lucky. My Pokemon bag is starting to look like the boys' club. Got all male Pokemon so far. And I'll have to check their stats after this. I forgot to do that. Because I do the mischievous or the Pokemon's nature kind of thing for which stats are boosted or if you have any stats that are boosted and decreased based on their nature. Okay, we've got Roger to level 5. Let me go heal my Pokemon and then maybe we'll try to see if this person wants to fight. Because I could always use the money. Let's see what Ant has to say this time. She always has something interesting to say. I mean, it does repeat off and on, but there are a couple really good ones. Hello, honey! Take a break from all that tiring adventuring. It's quiet without you around, you know. Oh, and he just talks more, like, when it says the father thing twice in a row, it really seems like she's pushing it there. Like, you know your father, the one who doesn't talk to you? Have you heard from him? No? I'll ask you next time you come back 5 minutes later. No, Auntie, I still haven't heard from him. And then I cry a little bit. He did send me my cell phone, though. I'm going to put Blanket in front, though. Because I have more faith in Blanket. Maybe this person won't want to fight, though. Oh, no. She does. You're a new trainer, huh? I just started, too. Maybe they'll suck. That's all we can hope for. Is that they suck a little worse than we do. Alton, level 5. I think it'll be okay. Okay, not very effective, that's good. And we've got static, so it's paralyzed. Which means we'll get to attack first. And if it's the only thing it's got is Peck, which it probably- oh, yay. This is all working out better than expected. That's not bad. Anyone can be a trainer, but some people seem more suited for it than others, don't you think? I wonder if that's self-deprecating. If she's like, now I just get to go home. I can just tell my mom I wasn't suited for it. I'm usually not big on collecting berries, but we'll see what we got going on here. Sure. You pick the 2 orange berries. Little Roy's put away the orange berries in the berries pocket. The soil returned to its soft and loamy state. At least I can sell them later if I need to, I guess. Most Nuzlockers have different rules about how they use status affecting, like, potions or berries. I'm gonna try not to use them in battle is kind of where I'm at. Okay, so there's a hill that we should be able to get to maybe from the other side. So that's all that's down here. We had a trainer and 2 berry bushes. Poor girl. Wow! Looks like you've got a head start on me! Well, maybe if you were training your Pokemon and not just standing around, I wouldn't have such a advantage. Okay. Want to put milk up front. I do like to keep my Pokemon pretty even when it comes to levels. I don't tend to favor one Pokemon over another when I'm training. Because it usually, I think it takes a solid team to really get through anything. Like, yeah, if a gym is weak to something I happen to have in my party, I'm going to use that one. But you never know. Okay, I think she wants to battle, so let me get a couple levels on Mocha, who I'm already kind of attached to. The only thing I wish they would have done different with Furby, because I think Furby's a really, really cute Pokemon, is it talks about how its feathers are all glittery and whatnot. I wish it would have transformed into a kind of peacock-type Pokemon. Because, I mean, they don't have one yet, and that always seemed like kind of a shame. Because all peacocks are mean, but they're also very cute. They're very cute. I don't think this is going to do much damage, yeah. Especially since it's a higher level than me. So we'll just get Roger in there. Just tackle him. Another interesting thing about Pokemon battles is, like, a lot of Pokemon follow the rules of a Pokemon battle. It's one hit at a time. You'd think a wild animal would be like, no, I'm not gonna wait for you to attack me to attack you back. But I guess the Pokemon world is a more civilized place than our own. Its growl sounds really cute too. Sounds like it's just like barking at us a little bit. I don't really know what sound chipmunks make though. Because I think it's just supposed to be a chipmunk. It sounds like a seal. That's what a sea lion. Sea lion. Those are the ones that bark. That's what it sounds like. I hate having to split experience, but with Mocha being really bad against chipmunks, because I guess they are electric already, even without electric moves. Ooh, this is good though. Bug Pokemon against my, because I do have Gust, which is my bird Pokemon, our bird move. So maybe we can one shot the Zulkabug. Nope. But it's working better. I always like the bird Pokemon. Like, I like Pidgey still a lot. Like, I know they're always one of the first Pokemon you get. Because, I mean, you usually get one in a Nuzlocke, too, because there's so many at the beginning of every game. But I always think they're real cute. They do a good job with them. Which seems like it would be a difficult thing, because yeah, there's a lot of species of bird, but most birds, you know, are pretty similar. But I've liked them all. Like, if I was a trainer, I might be a bird catcher, the one who carries around, like, the giant bird cage with him, which does not seem like a good idea. I'm almost at the next level. I'll try to get him to level 3 before I go back to Auntie's house. And then, maybe. Chin Monk! I'm just sending Blanket. There are a lot of electric rodents, though. I mean, this is a chipmunk electric. Pokemon's a mouse electric. Then there's all those other ones, Pichu and... which I guess is related to Pikachu, but then there's the one that's not Pichu, the little red and blue ones, that are electric as well. I wonder why that is. So many questions, so many unanswered questions. Leaving a wake of fainted Pokemon behind me. So Mocha's at level 3 now. Which maybe we can even set him up against Chin Monks now. Maybe it won't be so bad. It's rough not having a normal type move right off the bat. Because if it just has Gust and something's resistant to Bird, there's not much you can do. But again, thankfully, Chin Monk does not get an electric type move for a while. This game's just so pretty. So pretty. I live in Moki Town, even though it does not have a store. Oof, really spamming that father guilt. At least that old man has stayed away from my elderly aunts. I feel like one time I'm gonna go in there and he's just gonna be in my house. Oh, just keeping our elderly aunt company. You know how it is. Chin Monk. Well, we'll see what kind of damage Gust does now before I switch him out. Bet it's still not a lot. I bet it's still worth... I don't know. Oh, it's growling. We'll see. We'll do it this time. Because again, I hate splitting the experience when things are, you know, this low. Oh, I was gonna check my Pokemon out. I'm sorry guys for like the heavy sweatshirtness and hats, and you can't see, but I'm wrapped in 2 different blankets around my legs. The heat is not turned on in my apartment yet. And those of you lifting on the East Coast, getting mighty cold up here mid-October this year. He's got a jolly nature. So I guess that doesn't affect... Oh no, special attack up and speed down. That's okay for a bird Pokemon. Its speed down kind of sucks because it is faster. It's supposed to be a faster Pokemon, but special attack up with birds is worth it. Careful nature. And that, yeah, I'm okay with that as well for Roger. Special attack up, special defense down. Because that... it might run into trouble later, but it shouldn't be too bad. Then lonely nature. Aw, I hate it when they have a lonely nature. It just makes me want to, like, hug them and tell them it's all going to be okay. Attack down, defense up. That's fine, I guess. That's I think that's the worst one out of all of them. I mean, I guess the special special attack with Blanket's gonna be most important because water electric. Most of its attacks are gonna be special attacks. Trying to make coffee earlier and it's all getting cold. I just wanted to put my hands on at this point. I'd rather you growl with me right now than attack me. Much, you know. ...24 experience. At least it got me up to level 4. Mocha learned growl! Which I will never use. I'm not big on the stat changing. Like, if I had to answer all those questions in the quiz, I would end up with a fire type Pokemon. Just because I'm a very, like, I'm just gonna spam you with attacks until you're dead type of person. I like the grass Pokemon more. Even though in the quiz they say grass is very defensive. But like, unless it's really imperative that I try to paralyze something or something, I'll usually just use attack moves. Come on. Let's see, is she gonna ask about my father again? Whoa! I've been getting into indie game development! My latest project is called Pokemon Agate. I've got the coolest great aunt getting into indie game development. Let's just hope that she makes it big, and then maybe I can just come home and be a normal kid. Don't have to be a Pokemon trainer. Or maybe I can go be a ranger, like my dad, following my dad's footsteps. I'll be one of those people that are just like, Dad, please notice me. Oops. We are almost there. I'm almost to the point where I can fight that trainer over there. I know it's gonna be a Chinmunk that she's got out right next to her. But I just want one more level with my Burpee. Mocha. Maybe it won't be a Chinmunk. I know you did. Yep. I've got your number now, Chinmunk. Thank you. 24 experience. That's good. That's really good. If I get another one like that, then I'll be up to level 5 after one more battle, and then we can just heal up again real quick. And then I can move on instead of fighting in this same exact spot of grass. So, I know that you guys might be bored of it, and I'm also bored of it. But it's all part of the Nuzlocke game. Yeah, that's cool. Ooh, that's good. Here we go. And I'll get, since it was a level 3, I'll get the 24. Go up to level 5. Heal my Mocha one more time, and then we can move on. It all went according to plan. That woman still looks a little angry with me that I ran into her. She just has like this look on her face. It's like, I can't believe you, city folk. What's it gonna be today, Grandma? Or Auntie? Auntie. Great Auntie.
Don't you know, I tried to talk to Cam lately, and he just gave me the cold shoulder. How rude!
That's an odd one. I wonder why. Maybe he just feels guilty about not being able to save my mother. Who is not dead, hopefully. I mean, no one's seen her. But I know the rules of TV and games and stuff. Like, if you don't see a body, they're probably still alive. Okay, let's go straight towards that girl with her chin monk. I'm gonna try to not hold it against my chin monk that it is a chin monk.
Oh hey, little White! I just got a new Pokemon, and I want to see how it fares!
And then I'll kill it. Okay, and I'll probably switch my Burby out for Roger. Because it would just probably take forever for Burby to kill a level 5 chin monk. Oops. Fight. Tackle. Faster than me. Oh, Jesus.
I thought about it, considered it, but can't take risks like that at the beginning. I need that chin monk.
Man, this chin monk is faster than me. But it's paralyzed now. Critical hit. We'll put Verbi in.
Because they'll both just have Gust. It'll be fine. I want him even a higher level. I think it'll be okay.
Ooh, credit us. But we should hit first, and this should be the end of it.
Now just imagine how poorly that would have gone had I not leveled up all my Pokemon like I did. It's not as strong as I'd hoped. Yeah, you almost killed all three of my Pokemon. Not as strong as you'd hoped, though. That's okay. We'll just go back to Auntie's house. Which apparently we cannot shake Aunt's house. I mean, we will be back in Moki eventually. Because it's kind of a central location between a couple of things. But once we get out of Route 1, we won't have to come back here for a while. We just go to Pokemon Centers, since big cities have them.
I joined a swim aerobics class. It meets every Tuesday. Man, first Wii Tennis, now swim aerobics.
She's getting in shape. Probably for that skeezy old man. I know your number. I got you.
Now my Chinmunk's down a level compared to my others, so I will switch him in. Get him some experience. Make him a less crappy Pokemon. Make him the model that all Chinmunks should strive towards. When they make a dictionary or an encyclopedia entry for Chinmunk, it'll be a picture of my Chinmunk. I do like the fight music in this game as well. It definitely has that I'm doing battle kind of feeling to it. Okay. What did I come into this tall grass for? An antidote. I don't think there's anything poisonous around here. We'll see. I guess it must be coming up. They're giving us antidotes. One day you'll learn a good move. One day. It's like those contacts commercials that probably aren't on the air anymore because I don't have cable, so I have no idea what commercials are on. But back last time I had cable, there was that one day commercials for contacts. It was just like, one day I'm going to be class president. And there was a jingle or something or other. Oh, I learned to charge. the most useless of the electric moves when you don't even, especially when you don't have electric moves. Okay, what's this person doing living in the middle of nowhere? Let's talk to his daughter first. Let's make it creepy. Stop walking away from me.
My brother is a great fisherman! He loves water Pokemon!
Oh, that's just really sweet, actually.
No,
likes her. Hey, I'm a fisherman! These ponds next to my house have a wide variety of Pokemon. If you prove you are strong, I may give you my old fishing rod. But first, you need to defeat Maria. No, now talks city's gym leader. So this is a house we'll probably have to come back to just to get that fishing rod.
I wish I could use his bed.
Heal up. Not that I think we need it right now, but not having to go back to Auntie's house would be nice. Okay, I think that guy wants to battle. So we'll just get that first, whatever that is. Oh, chinmunks. So many chinmunks. Hope there's a chinmunk hunting season, thin the herd, because really, it's a lot of chinmunks. So many people eat Pokemon, like, they talk about different Pokemon having delicious tastes and whatnot. So, I mean, I bet you could hunt chinmunks for, like, meat or something. People eat squirrel. Found a potion. You know what? This guy is fishing. Let's put Mocha out. Another Burby. It's a level 2, though. We could probably beat it pretty easily. Fight. Experience. Okay, man. Do your worst. Did you know this river is populated mainly by Fortog? They are poisonous Pokemon. I'd carry antidotes if I were you. Well, he didn't want to fight. He just wanted to give me useful information. And, I mean, that was. I don't know, he doesn't have anything else to say. I love how the fisherman's like, there are many different things in this river. And he's like, there is one thing. There is one thing in this river. And they're poisonous. And they'll get you. Like, this bird just has all the makings to become a peacock, and it just doesn't, and it's so disappointing. I'm challenging you, Nintendo. Peacock Pokemon. Do it. I know that Sun and Moon is literally coming out in, like, a couple weeks. But, Peacock Pokemon, if you didn't already add it, go for it. Get it done. Gosh dang it. Hate Flash. Oh god. Where does the Flash even come from? What are you flashing? I guess, you know, they did say their feathers were shiny. I guess they could flash that. Okay, I take back I take back my complaint about where flashes come from on this bird. It's canon now. I figured it out. Okay. Let's do it to it, Blanket. A bug catcher? Hey, you! Yeah, you! Over there! We're gonna battle now, okay? An aggressive bug catcher. Doesn't he know that no one respects bug catchers? Because no matter how good you train up your bug Pokemon to be, it's still just a bug Pokemon. It's still gonna be weak against most things. I don't like bug Pokemon. Like, Kabug actually evolves into something pretty cool. It's a fairy type. But even then, I just don't like having it on my team. Blanket gained 53 experience points. Yay me. Yeah, I know that Roger's been hit already, but I'm sure he'll be fine. Go, Roger. Charge. I love that Charge is the first electric move you get, because there's nothing to charge. There's literally nothing. There are no electric moves. Nothing to charge. You're charging nothing. I still believe in you. I think this is gonna be fine. It's gonna be fine. I believe in it. That would have been really disappointing if he missed or something, actually. My thing would have died. I am probably, unless there's another person to fight up here, I think I can just go into town and heal up my Oh no, I have to go back, all the way back, to Aunt's house. Because I need to heal up my Pokemon before I can fight another person. Blanket uses Tackle. Critical hit. I always feel like I get the critical hits at the very end when I don't need them. Like they have one damage left on them and they're like, critical hit! They're super dead. No, I mean, not that I ever feel bad about getting a critical hit because good for me, but so long as I've gone, I think, without going back to Anne's house, she probably missed me. Actually, probably not, with her indie game development, her water aerobics class, and all that Wii Tennis. Oh. Tried to talk to Cam. I want the backstory on why he's being rude to my aunt. Like, there is no explanation for that at all. I mean, Cam always... I still don't like the way he talked to us when, he thought he thought that we made his son cry.
He's like, I swear if you did anything to him.
Like, you know what your kid's like. Chances are it wasn't me. Chances are he's just being a baby. I'm gonna put Chinmunk out front. Okay. Don't run away from- I wasn't. I knew what you were gonna do. I prepared myself for it. Oh no, not a dog. Remember, these are the poisonous Pokemon, and they do have poison sting, I believe. And they're one of those Pokemon, I think, that physical attack. Yeah, poison sting. And now I'm poisoned. I think Mocha's gonna have a better shot at Furtog. That wasn't too bad, okay. Oh, that really wasn't what I wanted either, though. I was hoping that would do more damage. I'll give it one more hit. We'll see what it does. If I get poisoned, I'm definitely putting in. Oh, God. Isn't that my second... Oh, but he didn't poison me. So I think this will be okay. Thank God. I hate Furtogs. I really do. Like, I hope I don't get one. Hey, you're pretty good. I want to trade Pokepod numbers. I'll win against you next time, yeah, I guess. Like, there's no point in not taking people's numbers. Like, I don't have to go back if I don't want to. Is this the way to town? Because I could really use a heal on... Look how much... How bad are we looking? Take... I should probably just antidote him, because I think this is a game where if you don't... get to the Pokemon Center in time, then your Pokemon does, you know, just die. And with the Nuzlocke and everything... Okay, let me find the Pokemon Center. Look at all these people we have to talk to. And I'm not going to talk to her. Well, I don't want to, but I will, I suppose. All she wants to tell you is how Pokemon Center works, which anyone who's played a Pokemon game ever, or watched the show, or heard someone talk about Pokemon, knows how Pokemon Center works. Okay. We'll talk to you first. We'll get it out of the way.
Ah, hello, young trainer! Is this your first time seeing a Pokemon Center? Come with me, I'll show you around.
I live this close to Kevlar Town and I've never been to a Pokemon, like... Just the worst.
A Pokemon Center, first and foremost, is sort of like a hospital for Pokemon. And a hospital is sort of like a place where people get medicine. My sister here will restore your hurt Pokemon to full health. But we aren't miracle workers. So unfortunately, we can't bring back Pokemon that have been lost forever.
Nuzlocke cannot bring Pokemon back from the dead.
Our services are completely free of charge, so feel free to use them as much as you like,
which we will.
That's not all there is in a Pokemon Center, though. To my left is a PC. It can be used to store items and Pokemon if you're already carrying 6 Pokemon, and you catch another, it automatically gets sent to the PC. Tandor's Pokemon storage system was developed by somebody named Twitch. So that's why it's called Twitch's PC. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. I haven't the foggiest idea who they really are, though.
I think this game is real witty. Just with the little things, but...
nudging. Up here, we have the Tandor Network. It allows you to connect with other trainers all around the world. If you talk to the attendants, they can fill you in on with more info. This concludes the tour. As thanks for listening, why don't you take these?
More orange berries. All for me.
We hope to see you again.
This guy looks cool. What's he have? There's a cave on the way to Nautalk City that's infested with strong Pokemon. Be careful. Say, trainer, what starter did you pick? Good decision. Electux is a well-rounded and able to beat a lot of different types, but careful of Grozard's magnitude.
Yeah.
Don't worry. We will be. Hate Grozard. Holy crap, I hate Grozard.
I'm raising my special Chinmunk. But even though they have powerful moves, we keep losing. Wanna fight?
Oh, I think that's a dude. Sorry, dude. Totally looked like a girl from the side. Mauli. Rich boy Mauli. Roger can take him. I'm sticking with that voice though, for Mauli. I'm committed. I'm not going back on that decision. Thankfully, since I'm in a Pokemon Center, I won't have to worry about healing up Roger. I'll just go over to the desk real quick.
Rich boy Mauli is about to send in Chinmunk. We switch your Pokemon?
No, just do it. Do it, Roger. Show him what the encyclopedia definition of a Chinmunk is. That you can beat up things of a lower level. Good job, Roger. Oh, there's another one. Yeah, then I guess I do have to switch out. We'll go Blanket. How many Chinmunks does this guy have? I mean, I understand, because there's so many Chinmunks around, it is tempting to just keep catching them, because they're there. But keeping them at level 4, they don't have anything at level 4. That's why you keep losing. I need to, like, sit him down and give him a talk. Explain to him why he keeps losing. Sweet. Tackle him. Little Royce defeated Rich Boy Mauli.
See? We keep losing! Nurse, can you heal my Chinmunk? Thanks. Now they're fighting fit.
Poor Rich Boy Mauli.
What's this?
We built a second floor for the Pokecenter, but we don't know what to put here. Oh wait, Tandor Network is up there. Well, I kinda, like, I'm worried about that old man, like maybe his memory's not what it used to be. Okay, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna explore the town a little bit, and then, that'll probably be it for today. I might do a little bit grinding off camera, I haven't decided yet, because, I mean, with Nuzlocke, you don't want to do too much off screen, because I don't want anyone to think I'm cheating, obviously, which I wouldn't, but we'll see.
It's so hard to get around these days. I wish they put in some roads.
Old man, just let me love you.
Hey dude, wanna hear a joke? Yes. Okay, listen. How do you get 50 Pikachu on a bus? You Pokemon! Haha, get it? Best joke ever.
That's Mori. He's always crying to people to get them to do something for him. And he wonders why he doesn't have any friends.
Who, this guy?
Sniffle, leave me alone.
I wish there was something I could do to help him. Like, cheer up, man. Things will get better. Okay, I'm gonna buy a couple of Pokeballs. I don't need that many. We'll get 5. And then we'll get 2 potions. And then we'll get 5 antidotes because, again, no, I want 5.
I don't want my Pokemon, like, this, that would be the worst. Just have a Pokemon faint because you don't happen to have an antidote at a specific time. Must be a pain to live in Moki Town, since there isn't a mart. Perhaps we should expand to there.
Yeah, man. I feel like you're missing out. I mean, there's only like 5 of us there, but
50% off Friday? Which Friday?
All Fridays? I guess if they don't put a date, then it must be all Fridays. Talk to you. Balding man, what do you need to say?
Hey. Did you know if you talk to people multiple times, sometimes they will say different things? Yeah, just like that. Good work.
It's probably more trouble than it's worth to talk to everyone twice. Especially since most of them will just say the same thing again.
Oh, an empty house.
They just leave their door unlocked. But again, like I said before, Pokemon is obviously a more civilized place.
Oh, look at this pretty lady with her pretty hat. We just moved to town. It's small, but homey. I think it'll be a good place to raise a family someday.
What about you, bro? Want to raise a family? She's talking about kids already. Why couldn't we raise some Pokemon instead? Dude. I'm gonna leave before, fight breaks out in that household.
What's in here? What's this guy doing?
Hey kid, you walked in here, which means that you need a bike repaired. Ah, you don't have one? Well, it figures. I haven't gotten many customers of late, now that I've already sold everyone in Kevlar Town a bike. Actually, if you bring me a bike wheel, I can fix an old bicycle and give it to you.
So, like, he doesn't have any business because he's already sold everybody a bicycle. And he's gonna fix that by...
I wanna get a bike, but the shop doesn't have any. What a lame shop.
Like, he wants to fix his business problems by giving me free stuff.
You've gotta train hard if you want to have any hope of beating Maria. She's a Nautalk City's gym leader.
Wow, it must be a really tough gym if he's just staring at the water like that. An existential crisis that he's having. I don't need any more Oran berries, but let's get a Pekka berry, Peacha berry. Yes, I did. Welcome to Kevlar's Berry Shop. Take a free sample of Tandor Most Delicious Berries. A little typo there. Your Pokemon will love them. Obtained Baku Berry. Obtained Wara Berry. Obtained Cuckoo Berry. Obtained Ake Berry. And what about you? My girlfriend is mad at me, so I'm buying her flowers to get her to forgive me. Good luck, man. At least you're better off than the guy who just wants to get a pet instead of having a kid. So that's a new route. Let's see, what time is it? It's 12:45. Work at 1:30. Do. Maybe I'll catch my route to Pokemon, and then we'll call it quits. Cause there's gonna be quite a bit of grinding. Cause I don't remember what the first gym's Pokemon levels are, but I know I've got to be at least level 10, if not maybe a little bit higher than that, level 12 maybe. Oh, look, I get to catch a Kabug. Good for me. It's fine. Like, I won't keep it in my party after I catch my 7th Pokemon, most likely. But, I mean, it's not a bad Pokemon. It's not. Maybe what I'll do to get ready for the next video, which will be tomorrow most likely, since I'm working the night shift tonight, is I'll at least get Kabug up to where my other Pokemon are, so that we don't have to watch me grind him from level 3 up to level 7. Cause that's, I can't really do anything else until I get him to a better level. It shares characteristics with bug and mammal Pokemon. Being in its presence has a calming effect. He's a love bug Pokemon. Love bug. So cute. Give him a cute name. His name is Fuzz Wuzz. Like Fuzzy Wuzzy. Which I don't think I could fit. Okay, and we'll call it there for today. Thank you so much for joining me, if there was anybody out there watching. And I will see you guys tomorrow, to do a little bit more grinding and maybe make it up to the first gym. We'll see. I do work a little bit later tomorrow, so I can put a little bit more time in. Yep, it's okay to override it. I saved the game. Okay, so have a good rest of your day, guys. I hope it goes beautifully.